Okay, so we're going to have a look today at adding two 8-bit binary numbers together. Okay, so I've got two 8-bit binary numbers. There's one, there's the other one. And I've got some rules, okay, and these are the rules that we need to use to add these numbers together. And I'll explain how these work as we work out the answer to the first one, okay? Now, if you're asked to do this in an exam, I would highly suggest you copy out a table a bit like this. So we have a carryover row, okay? So when I talk about carryover, I mean when you do column addition normally, sometimes you carry numbers over to the next column. That's what this is for. And I've got a total row here, so we can work out the total of our two binary numbers added together. So this is what we do. Now I've put an X up in the first one here. We're working from the right to the left. I put an X here because there's no carryover, because there's no column here, okay, on the right. So this is what we are going to do. We start by looking at our first column. So we have a 1 and a 0 in it. So we look down here at the rules. If we have 1, 1 and any number of zeros, we put 1 in the total and carry over 0 to the next column. Okay, so let's do that. So 1 there, and carry 0. Okay, so now we've got three zeros. So you can see here, three zeros, we put 0 and we carry 0. Okay, same thing. All right, three zeros, so 0, carry 0. Same as the first column here, we've got 1, 1 and 2 zeros. So 1, 1, 2 zeros. So we do 1 in the total and we carry 0. Okay. Now this time something slightly different. We've got two ones and a zero. So look, two ones and a zero, zero carry one. Okay, this is slightly counterintuitive because you would have thought two ones added together would make two. But remember, in binary, we can only use zero and one. So two ones added together as zero carry the one to the next column. Okay, this column much the same. Look, we've got two ones and a zero. Okay, there you go, there's the rule, two ones and a zero. So again, zero, carry one. Okay, something slightly different here. We've got three ones. Okay, so let's look down here at the rules. Three ones is one, carry one. So we'll put one there and we'll carry one over. Okay, so now we've got two ones and a zero. So here, two ones and a zero is zero in the total, carry one. Okay, well look, we're out of columns. So if this happens, what you do is you create a ninth bit. See here, I've got 8 bits. I've made a new ninth bit with the carryover, which was one. And if this happens, we call this overflow. Okay, sometimes it's called an overflow error. Okay, now here's an example of where that can be a bad thing. So in 1996, there was a rocket launched by the European Space Agency called Ariane 5, and it exploded after an overflow error in the computer that controlled the rocket. What happened was the computer in the rocket was a 16-bit computer, okay, so it could handle 16 bits. The software, however, was written for 32-bit. So what happened is two integers were added together. This created an overflow, a 17th bit, which the computer couldn't handle. As a result, the computer crashed and the guidance system on the rocket took it over the sea and blew it up. Okay, nobody was hurt. It was an unmanned rocket and everything was okay, apart from the $370 million bill, which was caused by a simple overflow error. Okay, so that's how to add two 8-bit binary numbers together. Okay, so try it yourself. Get two random 8-bit numbers, follow these rules, okay, and then you can verify it works by converting these two 8-bit binary numbers to a deanery number, converting the total, including the ninth bit if you have one, to a deanery number, and then in deanery add up the two numbers and does it equal the total that you've got. Okay, so that's a way of verifying if you've got it correct. So give it a go yourself, but make sure you're following these rules when you do it.